Dear students, today we discuss about the crystal oscillator. You might have aware of crystal oscillator. You know well that the electronic watches, the microprocessor, the timing controller circuits consist a crystal oscillator. It is a one type of oscillator which gives a constant timing. The oscillation with constant timing. In the case of LC oscillator and RC oscillators, the tank circuit consists of capacitors, inductor coil, resistors. When the time increases, the resistance in the resistor, the reactance in the capacitor, and reluctance in the inductor coil values varies. When the temperature of these components increases, this reactance, reluctance and resistance values varies. So these components, the value of C, the value of L decides, the value of R decides the frequency of the output waveform. When the value of L, C, R changes, automatically the frequency of the output wave changes. So we can't get the constant frequency output wave for longer time. But in the case of crystal oscillator, we get a constant frequency output. You know what is crystal? The solids are divided into two types. One is amorphous type, another is crystalline type. In amorphous type, the solid consists of the molecules. The molecule consists of atoms. In amorphous solid, the atoms are randomly arranged. But in the case of crystal, the crystal is a crystalline solid in which the atoms, molecules and ions are arranged in the ordered manner. It is the difference between amorphous and crystalline solid. So the crystal oscillator uses the crystal, its dimension decides the frequency. And the crystal is the main part of this oscillator, which generates the constant frequency output oscillations. The crystal oscillator is an electronic oscillator circuit. It working on the principle of inverse piezoelectric effect of quartz crystal. What is piezoelectric effect? When a compression and when a mechanical force, when a mechanical force is applied on the crystal generates the electrical power. So, when the external mechanical force is applied on the crystal, it generates the electrical energy, it is the current or voltage. It is known as piezoelectric effect. Here, the oscillator works with the principle of inverse piezoelectric effect. If you apply electrical energy, current or voltage, the crystal produces the oscillations. The oscillations is depends upon the external electric energy applied and the size of the crystal. The frequency decided by the size of the crystal we used in the crystal oscillator. Now we discuss about the construction of crystal oscillator. The crystal oscillator also consists of a tank circuit and an amplifier network and a feedback network. In the tank circuit, it consists of the two capacitors C1 and C2. Here, the crystal is the one of the part of the main part of the tank circuit. And the another part is the amplifier. The amplifier consists of the transistor, NPN transistor. The emitter is biased using the emitter resistor RE. As it is the N-type material, the emitter is made up of N-type semiconductor material. So, it always be given forward bias. So, the negative voltage is given to the emitter through the emitter resistor RE, which this resistor also used to stabilize the circuit. And the potential divider resistors R1 and R2 used to bias the base. The base is always be given a forward bias. The base is made up of P-type semiconductor material. So, the positive voltage is given to the base. So, the external battery source, DC source plus VCC, R1, the resistor R2 used to provide a necessary positive forward bias to the base of the transistor. And the collector is biased using a radio frequency coil. It offers two advantages. One is it is used to provide a DC bias, and as well as it used to free the circuit output from being affected by the AC signal on the power lines. And the C, it is another capacitor connected across the resistor R2, and it is the feedback path. So, the path is taken again to the base of the transistor. This crystal oscillator generates a constant frequency output. In this circuit, the resistor network R1 and R2 provides voltage divider network. RE is the emitter resistor, stabilizes the circuit, and the capacitor C1 and C2 forms a capacitive voltage divider like the resistance divider R1 and R2. The capacitor C1 and C2 forms the capacitive voltage divider network. And the main part of this circuit is the crystal. The crystal is suitably cut. You know well that the size of the crystal is mainly responsible for the production of frequency, the oscillation with the particular frequency. So, the dimension of the crystal is very, very important in the crystal oscillator. So, the crystal is suitably cut and mounted between two metallic plates as shown in this diagram. The working of the crystal oscillator. When the power is switched on, the power is supplied to the oscillator. The power is applied across the two plates of the crystal. When the alternating voltage is applied across the surface of the plates and the surface of the crystal, it vibrates with the natural frequency. These vibrations are converted into oscillations. Now the crystals start to produce the oscillations. So, the crystal oscillator gives the oscillations in its output with constant frequency. Here the crystal behaves like a series or LC circuit which is connected parallel with the capacitance of the electrodes. Cp is the capacitance of the electrodes and Cs, Ls, Rs is the LCR equivalent LCR circuit of the crystal. It is the equivalent LCR circuit of the crystal. It is the capacitance of its electrodes. So both are connected parallel as the crystal is mounted between the two plates. Due to presence of the electrodes and the crystals, the crystal will resonate at two different frequencies. In the presence of Cp, the crystal will resonate at two different frequencies. One is series resonance frequency, another one is parallel resonance frequency. In series resonance frequency, the series resonant frequency occurs when the series capacitor Cs resonates with the series inductance Ls. At this stage, the crystal resistance, the crystal impedance will be least, and hence the amount of the, as the resistance is small, the feedback will be large. So the amount of feedback will be largest in this series resonant frequency. So the frequency, the mathematical expression for the frequency of series resonant frequency is the series resonant frequency or the first part is equal to F sub S, S is in the series frequency, series resonant frequency is equal to 1 by 2 pi root Ls into Cs, a series capacitor and series inductor coil. In the case of parallel resonant frequency Fp, which is exhibited due to the reactance, that is a resistance, the reluctance and reactance present in the inductor coil and reactance present in the capacitor. So the totally this resistance, the total resistance of the inductor coil and the capacitor lags equals to the reactance of the parallel capacitor Cp. So the resistance offered by Ls, Cs and the resistance offered by Cp are equal. That is, the inductor coil, series inductor coil Ls and capacitor Cs resonates with the parallel capacitor, the plate capacitor Cp. At this instant, the crystal impedance will be very high. So, as the resistance is high, the feedback will be low. The feedback will be least here. So, the mathematical expression for this parallel plate frequency is 1 by 2 pi root Ls. Here, the two capacitors Cp and Cs are in series. So, this resultant capacitance Cp Cs by Cp plus Cs is taken. So, the frequency Fp is equal to 1 by 2 by root Ls Cp Cs divided by Cp plus Cs. So, this crystal oscillator operating in the range of, it generates the output oscillations with 40 kilohertz to 100 megahertz. So it generates the output wave with constant frequency in the range between 40 kilohertz to 100 kilohertz. Now we see the advantages of the crystal oscillator. As the crystal is very small, so it is a compact in size, and it is a quartz crystal, so it is very low cost, due to which the extensively using electronic components. Uses: the crystal oscillator uses in the electronic watches, microprocessors, microcontrollers, and the space tracking system, measuring system, a number of medical devices, PCs, digital systems, and modems, sensors. It has many more applications. So, even in the video game cameras, toys, video games, radio system, and the main usage here is the cellular phones and timers. And in microprocess, it is used to supply a timing circuit and to control the different peripherals available in the microprocessor and to give the timing to the different ICs present in the motherboard, that is in the processor.